Hello, Mike here with this week's new and trending AI tools you cannot afford to miss. It's been a busy week this week. I was at the podcast show in London, and these little business cards here went down a storm generated by Midjourney and edited and designed inside Adobe Express. I met so many amazing people at the event, hosted a panel on AI-powered podcasting, and every single podcaster that I had the pleasure of chatting with was keen to talk about AI tools. Make sure you subscribe to the channel, throw a like on this video, because very soon in the coming weeks, I'll release a video all about AI tools for podcasters specifically, based on my learnings from the podcast show in London. It was also the Microsoft Build event in Seattle, USA, this week, and they had a ton of new announcements, including the fact you'll need to be looking for an NPU very soon. So what exactly is an NPU? Well, it's a new chip, just like a CPU, Central Processing Unit, or GPU, Graphics Processing Unit, but this is a neural processing unit, and it's based on the wiring of the human brain and will allow creators to do pretty amazing things, such as this. The NPU will optimize Adobe apps such as Photoshop, Lightroom, and Express, and coming soon, Illustrator and Premiere Pro 2. If you're interested in AI in Adobe apps, by the way, I'll be talking to Premiere Gal on this week's Creator Magic podcast.
World jumping? Where you're like jumping into new worlds based on just a text prompt. So, you know, I snapped my fingers and said, you know, in the style of a comic book, snap my fingers again, in the style of an apocalyptic world or something.
But it's not just Adobe. DaVinci Resolve Studio will get optimizations through the NPU for magic masking. CapCut will allow you to remove backgrounds. And DJ Pro, an app close to my heart, will allow you to remix stems of music tracks in real time. This is pretty insane. You can change the level of drums, instruments, and vocals. But tying this back to Microsoft, the NPU will allow you to use Cocreate in apps such as Microsoft Paint. Now, I haven't used that for decades because I hated generating BMP files. But now you'll be able to draw on the screen, and Copilot will instantly create a masterpiece based on your directions. This is all part of the Copilot Plus PCs that were launched at Microsoft Build. They'll be available from the 18th of June, so not too long to wait. And big brands such as Dell announced they'll start their pricing from $1,099. HP and Lenovo both starting from $1,199. So a pretty reasonable price for an AI-powered PC. But the announcement I found most interesting at Microsoft Build was the fact that Microsoft Edge soon will be able to translate YouTube videos and other videos in real time while you watch them.
Plugins to incorporate your own business data.
Del día trabaja. Ahora puede conectarse a bases de datos.
So that's pretty cool. You just hover over the video, click the real-time translate button, and Microsoft Edge browser does the rest for you. But it's not just Microsoft. YouTube is working to integrate allowed AI dubbing into the YouTube studio, alongside a rollout of multi-language audio as well. Rene actually tweeted from YouTube's creator liaison to say there's no specific timeline yet, but we'll keep everyone updated. Dubbing can, of course, go wrong, just as I found out when I interviewed Nick Nimmin, the YouTube growth expert, on the Creator Magic podcast last week.
It gave me a woman's voice. And I didn't notice it until somebody said something in the comments.
So in tribute to getting dubbing sounding right in your own voice, I wanted to test a trending AI tool that a lot of creators are using right now. And they're well known for their AI voice cloning, but ElevenLabs also have a dubbing studio that I'd like to show you now. I've got a YouTube video of mine. It's actually related to the OpenAI voice scandal of Sky sounding similar to Scarlett Johansson. That broke also in this week. I've got this video, it's a couple of minutes long, and I'd like to change it into a different language, but retain my voice. So I've copied the URL, and here I am in ElevenLabs dubbing studio. I'll leave a link to this in the description down below. It's great for social media content, media and entertainment, marketing, education, e-learning, and so much more. And I'm going to give this a name. So let's call this Open AI voice, like so. Now I can select a source language if I like, so English will be my choice, and then I can choose a target language. So let's go for French here. Now, of course, I can go ahead and upload something, but if I've got a YouTube video, I can select YouTube here and paste in my URL. Now, I can also create a dubbing studio project here. And there you go, my dub really took no time at all, maybe just over a minute, and I can go into edit to enter the dubbing studio here. Now, this is cool because it looks very familiar to me as an audio professional. This is just like an audio editor. So you can see the background noise is here, you can see speaker one is here, and speaker two is also highlighted. So I can play things back and listen to how the dub sounds. Hey there, Mike here. Okay, that's sounding pretty good to me so far, but I can switch over to French down here, and immediately you see that you get everything from English translated into French here, and I can play again.
Salut, c'est Mike, et je pensais essayer un format de vidéo différent où je vous apporte simplement un peu d'actualité de la semaine et voir ce qui...
Now, this is the beauty of something such as a dubbing studio in ElevenLabs. I can actually go in and correct the transcript if something is incorrect in the translation. And you'll see here, where I say in English, the use of their voice, Scar, and then it changes it into French, but it says the word in French for sky, céleste. I want to keep it as sky because that is the name of the voice. So it's a simple correction. Double click here, type the word sky, and regenerate the audio.
L'utilisation de leur voix sky.
Oh, no.
Okay, another thing I notice when I'm playing back here, sky clashes with my last words. I'd like to correct that. That's really easy to do. Scroll down here and you'll see this is Sky speaking in French. I can actually drag to make that a bit smaller, just like I would in an audio editor. Play back again.
L'utilisation de leur voix Sky.
Oh no.
And you'll see that I have the ability to go through each track individually and make edits. And I can also see a waveform, so I can really dial in my dubbing for my YouTube videos or anywhere that I'm uploading to inside the ElevenLabs dubbing studio. I recommend you try it out using the link down below and throw a like if you're enjoying the video so far. And when we've finished creating our dub, just click export here and you can choose what language you'd like to export in and also the format here and you'll get an instant download. Next up, AI music generation has gone local. This is absolutely incredible. You can run your own AI music generator at home privately, even without an internet connection. It's a project I found this week on GitHub called MusicGPT. Now, don't be disturbed that the code is on GitHub. That just means that it's open source and anyone can download and use it. If you actually go to the project page that I'll post in the description down below, you'll see a brief introduction video here and also install instructions for Mac and Windows. Here, these download links, you can actually download files that you can run on your Mac or Windows computer that will do the install and run MusicGPT for you. So no coding experience or knowledge required. If you want to be a little more advanced, there are Docker instructions, and actually that's how I'm running it over here on my PC in a Docker container that allows me to access the MusicGPT interface on my computer. Once you get it up and running, either via the PC or Mac installers or via the command line, you'll have a web page that looks like this. This is running entirely locally on your computer. You can disconnect now from the internet and still run this. Now, note you might need a fast chip such as the Mac M3, M4, the new NPU processors for PCs, or if you've got a graphics card, I'm using a GPU. Actually, it's quite an old one. It's an NVIDIA 2070 Super. So I'm going to say a dance track with synths and drums, and let's actually say 120 BPM. So we'll keep the first prompt really simple, and let's see how long it takes. Now, this is running in real time, so you can see how my NVIDIA 2070 Super handles it. If you had a 40 series GPU, or even the new NPUs or processors on Mac, I'm sure this would run a lot faster. So it's generating an audio response for me, and very shortly, I'll have the finished track in a little music box that I can play or download from my local music generator. And you know what? That's not bad. Now, I'm using the MusicGen Small Language Model, and this is created by Meta. It's actually an open source project. You can change up if your graphics card can handle it. You can go to medium or large, but of course, remember that's going to take a lot more time to generate tracks. Let's try again. This time, I'll enhance my prompt, and you'll actually see here I've got fast-paced electronic dance music, bassline, uplifting synth leads, track is energetic. So I'm giving the LLM a lot more to work with here as it generates my music. Okay, feeling a little bit repetitive, but we can start a new chat by going up into the menu here, and you'll see the history of the tracks I've been generating so far. Let's go new chat, and this little prompt here will ask for a 1970s disco club track. That was not really the best, was it? Let's give it one more try. Let's go to a new chat, and this time I'm going to put in a reggae-style ocean beach song and see what comes back. I got to say, it's pretty prompted here and there, isn't it? Let's go into the menu, start a new chat, and this time we will go for something that's got mystery and tension. Actually, at the start of the piece, I've asked for a deep cello melody accompanied by soft echoing synth. So let's see how well that comes out. I'm actually going to make this a 30-second piece and see how it does. Okay, and this one took significantly longer, but is it worth the wait? It is definitely giving me the sense of mystery and tension there. Dark and brooding. I'm searching, maybe there is a cello in there somewhere. Yes, there's definitely a cello in there. Interesting music. Now, of course, I can download this track if I want to analyze it, and I will, just to tell you the quality of this local AI music generator. And I've just pulled it into Adobe Audition so I can analyze. The sample rate is actually pretty good at 32,000 hertz. It is a mono generation that this is creating, so no stereo tracks, unfortunately, in waveform as we'd expect. So really, not too bad, but we could ask for stereo in the future, maybe. MusicGPT is a fun little project that I suggest you go and check out and support. It's available for Mac, Windows, Linux, or Docker, depending on what flavor you're interested in. It's also got great usage guide here, so you can choose between the models and links to all of the Facebook models on Hugging Face if you want to see what is the best music generation model for you. And obviously, the larger and more parameters, the better the quality of music I'm sure you'll get back from this. Finally, as a content creator, I'm always looking to get feedback on how you're reacting to the stuff I make. And the final AI tool is actually called Formshare. It brings chat forms to life using AI to really quiz the person who's answering in a personal way. Let me show you how it works. Now, you can use this for free, which is what makes it so powerful. And it's actually created by a company called Chatbot Kit, which are in the business of making chatbots. So I'm just going to sign up. And here we go. I'm in the dashboard. It's really as easy as that. I can create forms for free now. So let's try a basic one. So to get started, I'm calling my form Creator Magic Feedback. And for the description, I'm saying that it's a form designed to gather your feedback, the audience feedback on preferences, challenges, and interests related to AI tools and content creation. So let's create. And you know what? That's all I needed to do. Now I've got a feedback survey that you can fill out. And actually, I'll link it down below if you're interested in filling it out and improving the content on this channel. So let's take a look through at what's been created for me. This is an audience feedback survey helping to improve the Creator Magic content. And we've got some sample questions here. So it asks for the respondent's name. That's perfect. How frequently they watch videos. Also, what kind of tools and content they're interested in and the challenges they're facing around content creation. And of course, any additional suggestions as well. Now, if I want, I can get rid of a question by crossing it. I can move it around in order like so, but I'm going to leave it exactly as default. Next, I'll go to design where I can actually change the background color if I want. I can also go ahead and change things like the color of the text just to suit my specific survey style. Okay, if I'm happy with what I've got, I can save and publish here. Now I can go over to share and you'll see I get a link that I'll put down below and you'll see that the replies will come in over here on the right. So let's try it out. And here is my form ready to interact with. I'm going to get started as the first respondent and you'll see this kind of ChatGPT style interface that comes up. Hey there, what's your name? So I'll just say Mike like that. And that's pretty neat the way it responds to me personally. So I'll say I watch weekly. Now it's actually giving me a multi-choice response. So I'll say I quite enjoy the tutorials. And then it's asking me the challenges I face. I'll say there are just too many tools I don't know what to use. And I've made a spelling mistake deliberately there. Then it's asking me for additional suggestions. I'll just say keep it up. Now, looking back at my replies here inside Formshare, you'll see if I refresh, I've got one positive sentiment. So it's marked as a positive sentiment here, which I can then analyze and look at everything. And yes, it still retained my spelling mistake, but everything is now contained here. And over time, I'll build up a picture of what my audience like. So there you go. That's Formshare. I'm enjoying it so far. It's a great way to interact with your audience as a creator and get feedback with a personal touch using a bit of generative AI. And I hope you've enjoyed the incredible AI tools this week. If you did, throw a like on this video, subscribe to the channel down below because I've always got videos just like this one coming up. And if you really enjoyed my tools that I was sharing with you, there's a ton more that Nick Nimmin shared on the podcast last week, all related to YouTubing and optimizing your content with AI, such as generating short clips and also translating your content too. That video is showing up on your screen, and you can also access it using the link down below. Go and have a listen now. Well, go on then.